So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This fielded at the two. And he's going to be stopped dead in his tracks. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. That goes for a gain of 31.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
And he's going to go out of bounds at the 30-yard line. And a nice carry there of 15 yards. Last year, Gurley. A 74% of carries. That's the highest percentage in the league.
But no real payoff, because they finished 31st in the league in rushing. I think as a team, they ran for 78 yards per game. They had a 1,000-yard receiver and Kenny Britt out wide, but they really didn't scare people downfield. And because of that, they stacked the line of scrimmage and stuffed the run game.
They go play action here on first down. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38. DeMarcus Lawrence in there to bring him down for a loss of 7.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Now Goff will hand this one to Gurley. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Larry Ridley is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. Here's Goff. Cowboys pressure gets there this time for the sack. Tyrone Crawford in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that'll lead to a 4th down.
I remember when I was a kid and all I wanted was a nickel so I could get that soda down at the fountain. And guess what? The nickel came into play well. 5 defensive backs, they covered well, allowed for the sacks.
Sodas were a nickel when you were a kid?
No, I just needed the extra nickel so I could pay the proper price.
Okay, how much were they? A dime? What were they?
15 cents.
On now is the big leg of Greg Zuerlein. He has hit from as far as 61 away in his career. They spot it on the midfield stripe, so it is a 60-yard attempt here. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short, no good, and this game will remain tied here in quarter number 2.
And this is one of the risks you run when you attempt a long field goal. If you miss, the defense takes over to spot of the placement, so now they've got a chance to get one more drive in before halftime.
Prescott dancing to his left. Oh, he's looking long for Witten. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. They had to fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. And he's brought down. Prescott finding his big receiver, Bryant, there for a Cowboy first down. First down, Prescott. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
A second down throw for Prescott. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. Cole Beasley, the intended target. And that takes us from second to third down.
Tremendous field position there and a perfect time to do exactly what they did. Take a shot at the end zone. And they went for the big play, just unable to complete it.
Right side complete to Butler. And that one good for 16 yards and a first.
Looked like the screen pass was taken away there, but what a nice job improvising, finding other options, and completing the pass anyway.
To throw is Prescott. His throw caught at about the five. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Now Elliott. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the six. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Second down, Prescott. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. A bit of a surprise. They're going for it with two ticks remaining. No sign of the field goal unit. Final play of the half, Prescott. And he fires one, but incomplete. So a touchdown apiece. And never mind, Larry. These two teams apparently anxious to get back at it. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Rams offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. Looking left side for Watkins, and he's got him. Goff to Watkins for a Rams first down. So the offense has it first and 10. Turns and gives to Gurley. And some space here. He had a great move, but he'll still be stopped shy of midfield. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
Getting out a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Another carry now for Gurley. And he'll be brought down right at midfield after a gain of only a couple.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Try and pick up the first with Gurley. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
Throw here is incomplete. Cooper Kupp was his intended target. That'll bring up second down. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Call it a gain of four, and it'll leave them with a third down and six to go.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action, hit him over the top.
It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he is knocked down from the side. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he could scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. The Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. Their defense did its job, yielded no points. Now it's the offense's turn.
And how much fun is that when you set things up to start a half and you just tell you guys, hey, if you can shut them down, get it back for our offense, we can roll. And they played out perfectly. Now, can the offense do what they wanted to do at the half, which is find those weaknesses and now attack them and score some points.
And break this tie. Throwing, Prescott, throwing the out route and complete. That's Bryant, and he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. Prescott on first down, rolling to his right. Bryant with a catch right side. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. A gain of 32 that time. And the young buck showing that ability, that agility to... outside of the pocket, complete the deep ball.
And don't think for a second that the coaching staff didn't have their heart rate accelerate a little bit there, right? Anytime you have those young quarterbacks and they get outside of the pocket, you're just hoping that they make good decisions because so many things can happen that can go wrong when you throw it downfield like that. He got away with it there and in a big way. Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Terrence Williams, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cowboys have taken the lead.
I know we often laugh, and sometimes we even exalt the guys who are great trash talkers and give us some really funny lines. But the bottom line is absolute production on the field. His second touchdown of the game, and they lead.
And now they'll be looking to their defense to preserve that lead. Bailey now to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And the Rams now coming out on the field. And, you know, their previous possession, they were able to move the football, but still wound up punting in the end.
You know, in 2016, Carolina had a 20-play drive that lasted over 10 minutes. And remember how it ended?
In a punt.
Yeah, I mean, how does that happen? You just don't see that happen every day.
And this one maybe not quite that bad, but still, you'd like to have a chance for points if you hold the football that long.
Agreed.
They'll start out on the ground with Gurley. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but a guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Back now in Arlington. It's the Rams trailing, but they do have the football as we start the fourth and final quarter. They'll stick to the ground game with Gurley. A big hit. Knocked down sideways, right at the line of scrimmage. Only a yard on the pickup, so a good situation on second and two. It's now third and one.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. They control the clock, they control the ball, and that way you often control the game. How about the fellas with the stars on the side of their helmets rising up on defense? We always hear about the Cowboys rushing offense. Their rush defense is pretty good as well, I think because they're so cohesive. Defensive line, linebackers really work well together.
Here's Johnny Hecker now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Now this is fielded in the end zone. A nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the Cowboys will be backed up to start the drive. They'll have it first and 10. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. It doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
That throw good for 4. It's second down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on first and 10. Prescott from the gun. One incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. Throwing again. Prescott on second and 10. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Bryant. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Dez Bryant. 76 yards, and the Cowboys will add on to their lead. And they just ran the fly route there, didn't they?
You broke it down perfectly. He ends up catching that one and taking it all the way into the end zone.
Well, thanks. It was pretty simple to break down, though. I mean, that's just a guy. going, running on the go route, making a play.
Speed,
kills.
Speed, speed. And what does it do?
It kills.
There you go.
Bailey now for the extra point. It's good, and it is now 21-7. Bailey now to kick this one away. This fielded at the two. Now a hit and a loose football. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And they're going to be set up in the red zone right around the 17-yard line. And careless with a football there on the kick return.
And one thing I love about going to practices is trying to get around coaches.
And here we go on first and goal. On first and goal, Gurley. And he'll get this one up to the 26. He'll get two out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal.
Every team we ever talk to that continues to run the ball in a game, even when they haven't had much success, all talks about attrition, don't they? If you keep running it, eventually good things are likely to happen. It's been a hard go in this game today, hasn't it?
Yeah, this defense, they've met pretty much every challenge in front of them this afternoon.
They're still trying to run the ball, but they're not finding much space. That one didn't quite make it to the target, but that's not always a function of the strength of the arm of the quarterback, is it? Sometimes it's just too much pressure there. In any case, the ball doesn't arrive.
And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
Desperation time for Goff on fourth. It's incomplete. They can't hook up here on the fourth down pass attempt. And Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. So now with a two-minute warning coming up fast, that puts a mammoth dent in their comeback hopes.
I like how you phrased it. It's a dent because there's still opportunity. They've got to get the ball back on defense, obviously twice. But guess what? This thing is not close to being over. They need to go ahead and play it out.
Not over. As you said, two-score game still. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. Six, seven, eight, nine, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line. I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And they have just about put this one on ice as they've got it here, first and 10. Looking to throw, Prescott. Toward the pylon, caught. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Snags it for the pick. Their passing game has been spectacular this afternoon. Finally, a win for the defense.
You think maybe there was an adjustment there. Finally gained a measure of, I don't know if you call it revenge, but got a play done against him. And
Robert Woods. He's at the 50. 30. The 20. Touchdown, L.A. Robert Woods, an 80-yard touchdown. And the Rams have got this back to a one-score game.
And they put it in the end zone, which was job one. Now they have to convert. And then it's decision time, isn't it?
Yeah, this is what all teams go through. You look at the clock, you're inside 2 minutes, look at your timeouts, make that onside kick decision.
Yeah, how do you feel about your defense, where you are in terms of the scoreboard and the time left on the clock? As you noted, so many things to go through.
Those are the ones the offensive coordinators dream about. One play drives from that distance. What an effort. It results in the touchdown. And the Cowboys are able to recover. And now looking at the clock here, they do have two timeouts, but even if they force a three and out, they're going to have very little time remaining.
So that means they've got to be aggressive and find a way to knock the ball free. They've got to come up with it because they can't just rely, as you noted, on using their timeouts and getting the ball back. They might not have any time to mount an attack, even if they do play it that way. Get the football, that's their mantra.
Yeah, the Rams are going to go ahead and take another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. Prescott to throw, and he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Prescott. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
That's a first down if he holds on, but you saw the contact, able to jar it free from him and force a fourth down.
Great play defensively there, as you said, just to knock it free, because if he had caught that, pass the sticks, first down. Prescott to throw it, and that is incomplete. Jason Garrett might be wanting to reconsider the decision to go for it there. And the Rams are going to take possession of the turnover on downs.
Everyone gears up for third down, talks about the importance of it. But fourth down, that's truly the moment of truth play, isn't it?
Everything's dialed up a little bit more. And, it's such a momentum play, isn't it?
Absolutely, because it can flip either way depending on who converts on fourth down.
And he does take it in for the touchdown, but a flag on the field, and I don't think this is going to stand.
Yeah, don't put the points on the board just yet.
Illegal block in the ball. Offense.
Late game, that hurts. Take the touchdown off the board.
No doubt about it, and this is where you make a great movie scene, right? Go in, rally the team. Okay, we lost points there. Let's get it back and go out and score again. Can he get it done?
Back to throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
That's very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. He's back to throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Back to throw. They got a man. It's Woods. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. And with just over 40 seconds now remaining, he gets up and spikes it. And they're going to go soft on the corners. They'll look to throw. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. The Rams on third down. 3 for 7 so far in this game. This is third and 7. He'll look to throw. And now another one thrown incomplete. What a great sequence by this defense so far. They've given him nowhere to go with the football.
And they just have to make it stand up one more time because it appears that they've got their number. Can they not have a slip up here and allow the touchdown?
Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Orlando Scandrick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Orlando Scandrick just took the challenge right there. Find a way to seal the victory, and that's exactly what he did with that interception.
The product of Boise State coming up huge. Throwing here, Prescott. He's airing it out for Williams. It's caught inside the 25. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Now Prescott. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. They'll try the sweep with Elliott, and he stopped immediately there. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left. So now third and 10, a big play to start the drive, but nothing since. Now it's the Florida Atlantic alum. This is Alfred Morris. And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Now